I'm Dan Gray, and this is the fully revised 2017 Buick LaCrosse. Now, it's got changes outside and in. It is a wonderfully smooth and quiet cruiser. If you're in the market for a large luxury sedan, this one should be on your contenders list.
The 2017 LaCrosse is offered in four trim levels: Base, Preferred, Essence, and Premium. The LaCrosse shares its front-wheel drive platform with the Chevy Impala. It was first introduced in the 2005 model year, and the 2017 model marks the third generation. It's longer, lower, wider, and 300 pounds lighter than last year's model. We tested a front-wheel drive LaCrosse Premium in crimson red tint coat with a light neutral perforated leather interior.
The first wave of competition for the LaCrosse is within the GM family, of course, and that would be the Chevy Impala, the Cadillac CTS, and CT6, although the CT6 does get a whole lot more expensive and a lot more luxurious. From a size perspective, it's pretty close. Then you look to Lincoln and you look to Chrysler with the 300. This is a great competitor for all of those.
The 3.6-liter direct-injected V6 engine pumps out 310 horsepower and 282 pound-feet of torque. It includes a stop-start system for improved fuel economy in town and cylinder deactivation for more MPGs out on the open road. The V6 has made it to an efficient and quick-shifting 8-speed automatic transmission. The drivetrain is quite sprightly. We saw 0 to 60 times in the 6.5-second range. All-wheel drive is only available in the premium trim level. The 2017 Encore is EPA rated at 21 city, 31 highway with front-wheel drive, and 20 city, 29 highway with all-wheel drive. We had absolutely no problem hitting the numbers with our front-wheel drive tester. The cylinder deactivation feature allows the LaCrosse to outperform on the highway when driven conservatively. The LaCrosse provides a smooth ride, composed handling, and an extremely quiet cabin. This is one well-behaved whale. Sport mode changes the character of the car by tightening up the steering and delivering more aggressive shifts. The roomy and nicely appointed interior really sell the car. The Essence and Premium trim levels are trimmed with leather upholstery, and the front bucket seats are equipped with heating and ventilation. The premium trim level adds driver and front passenger power lumbar support with massage, as well as a heated steering wheel.
The steering wheel has a low-key design, but it's actually quite wonderful. The touch of the leather is good. The padding, for me, is perfect. Lots of stress-relieving padding up here by the thumb rests. There are paddle shifters, if you're gonna play boy racer or girl racer, and lots of controls. Now, the controls do get a little bit confusing. Over here on the left, you've got your adaptive cruise control, and below that, in the cruise buttons, is your heated steering wheel control. That took me a little while to find. Next to it, you've got your Bluetooth. Over here on the right, you have control over your multimedia and your center information display. And again here, it gets a little confusing. The buttons closest to the center of the wheel control your stations. The four-way button controls your center information display. And over here, you've got your volume controls.
The colorful heads-up information display helps you keep your eyes on the road. A backup camera is standard. The premium trim level provides a host of advanced safety technology, including forward collision alert, lane departure warning with lane keep assist, blind spot mirrors with lane change alert, and rear cross traffic alert. Our tester was equipped with a trio of option packages, along with the optional 20-inch alloy wheels. The driver confidence option package adds adaptive cruise control and automatic park assist, along with front automatic braking and pedestrian detection. The sights and sound option package adds navigation and a Bose CenterPoint surround sound system with 11 speakers. The IntelliLink infotainment system includes Apple CarPlay and Android Auto. If you use a smartphone, this represents a significant advantage over competing vehicles that do not. You'll find one 12-volt outlet at the base of the dash in the convenient storage cubby and a second 12-volt outlet inside the center console along with two USB ports. The sun and shade option package includes a panoramic moonroof and a power rear sunshade. The rear seat is wonderfully spacious with 37.2 inches of headroom, 40 inches of legroom, and 56.6 inches of shoulder room.
Wow, holy cow. There is an enormous amount of legroom back here. This seat is back to where I'm comfortable driving at 5'10", and look where it is. I've got five fingers to the back of the seat. Headroom, a bit tighter. I've only got four fingers of headroom, but still pretty good. Nice, big, squishy center armrest with two cup holders and a little tray in here for your stuff. Bottle holders in the doors. Down here on the console, we've got HVAC vents, but no control over velocity or temperature. And there are two outlets, one 12 volt and one house current. Overall, wow, is this comfortable? I like it a lot. It almost feels like a limo.
This big cruiser is ideally suited for golfers with a trunk that provides 15 cubic feet of cargo capacity. While that's less than the Impala, it's large enough to handle four bags of clubs. The rear seats fold down with trunk-mounted releases, and a temporary spare is located beneath the trunk floor. The 2017 LaCrosse is one of the best large sedans in the market, but some folks refuse to shed their historic perceptions of the Buick brand. The cabin is marvelously quiet, the engine is responsive, the ride is plush, and the LaCrosse handles better than any large Buick ever has.